I was told, sorry, the rain's really loud. I was told to log on because there was, oh, I guess I'm gonna be pranked, aren't I? Oh boy. I don't see anything yet. Did they put rail down to... In... I was looking at it. Did they put rail to me in the nether? What is this? Did they get sick of running backwards and forwards? Let's check it out. And now we're gonna wave the lag. There we go. For end-to-end production, yes. We're just going to turn those into sticky now. What? No! 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 this is... awesome. Oh. Quartz me up, baby. Schnackies. Hello. What they put on the netherrack. More beautiful quartz. Bing, 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 bing. It's almost as good as the iron smelting trick. Almost. Is this all the netherrack? Four MLS. Three netherrack. Courtesy of two crazy guys. Redstone Pimpernel and Diamond Duke. Thank you very much, guys. Oh my god. It's a bumpy old railroad, isn't it? That's incredible, guys! Oh, I'm obviously keeping it. It is the dorkiest thing I've ever seen. We can get really fast. Beep, 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 beep. Except when we hit the hole. I hope the lava doesn't burn any of these logs down. That's a lot of wood. I need wood. Oh man. So I'd like to talk briefly about the TV show Community. Now, this was a show that, when it first started airing, I found it, I tried watching it and I thought it would be really interesting, and I initially found it to be kind of boring, and they split the first season into, like they usually do in the States, And I didn't watch the second half of the first season, and that's where things really got kicking. Now, I was always curious, was it Dan Harmon who made the funny episodes, or was he responsible for the dramatic episodes, which I didn't care too much for? And the answer to that came in a Comic Con panel, where Dan was hyping up the first paintball episode, so he was very much behind that. So that then brings up season 4. So seasons 2 and 3 were just crazy awesome, fun, hilarious. I loved them. Very creative. Loved them very much. Wow, this is pretty fresh. And at the end of season 3, Chevy Chase and Dan Harmon supposedly got in a fight. And the network chose Chevy Chase over Dan. So the creator of the show no longer works on the show. As well as that, the guy who plays Starburns also left. And he was also a writer. And I think some other people left too. Well, 3/4 of the way through season 4, Chevy Chase and the network decide that he's gone too. They say that it's an amicable decision, and it probably was, but I think maybe they realized they got rid of the wrong person. The show in season 4 has most definitely been suffering. It's simply not as good as season 2 or 3. You know, the acting sometimes even feels staler. The high metaphor stuff that they did with Abed, they can't seem to pull it off. You know, all of Abed's fantasies might have been true, but in the latest ones, they're definitely not true. So, that's unfortunate. That's right, I was cooking more stone because I'm doing some building. Like the Freaky Friday episode, at the end of it, they were just two guys being playful and silly. So that, I think that's a real shame that the show has definitely suffered. So now they're left without all of their original writer talent, and the guy responsible for getting that writer talent kicked out. And I looked up Dan Harmon, see what he's been doing, and he's been doing an improv show with the likes of, Eric Idle? Of all people, Eric Idle? How do you rope Eric Idle into being in your improv show? Ryan Stiles and Greg Poops? Greg. And honestly, why should he come back? He's also just signed a deal to do a cartoon for Adult Swim, which I think will be a mistake. Blackwall, why don't we touch Blackwall on me? Because Adult Swim doesn't tend to make good things, but we'll see what happens. And so Community is suffering a slow death right now. It's lost its ability to be truly, truly innovative. How to fix this? I have an idea. Instead of the usual gap, let's do a different style gap. Still not great. So, last time I was talking, didn't have a roof here. This is going to be the map room. Map here, something else there, not sure yet. Bridge is here now. It's an odd roof, I'm not 100% on it. But the design for this place is now set. Let's go up a little bit higher, you can see that it's actually essentially a peace sign. So, bam bam, third, well, a quarter, a fifth. Is that a fifth? Two fifths, two fifths. So I haven't got any windows in yet, but this is the bedroom here. This is going to be a central fireplace. Speaking of which, let's just stick this here for now. It's not how it's going to stay. And then remodeling the interior here. This is essentially a connector between the lounge room here, the rest of the keep, and my bedroom. So I'm going to put, you know, I'm going to do Vintage Beef's piano in here, because that is just inspired awesomeness. And I'm going to try and do a laptop as well in here, also inspired awesomeness from Vintage Beef. Man, that guy, he's so good. Really, really good. And this fifth here is actually going to be two-story, so we'll get a nice view, and we'll also get an interesting shape. Because it's all about the shape, for me at least. Aesthetics is important, though I am struggling with moves a bit. Oh, thank goodness. The noise is gone. The noise is gone. I don't know how tall I want these rooms to be. This is my home. You know, this is one thing that I wanted to test out now that we have carpet. If you put glowstone underneath carpet, does it actually light the place? If it does, well, that's every lighting problem solved pretty much ever. So you've got these sort of little airlock type things here. Oops. Gives a fair bit of privacy, see? I may end up closing this one off and just having the fireplace between these two. We'll see. Okay, so glowstone underneath carpet. I don't have any glowstone on me. Either that or torches. One or the other. Hey! Mobs. Mobs are back. I think Magic might have restarted the server. Because we just basically weren't getting many mobs at all. It was really weird. In a half-hour caving expedition to get the iron ore to do that experiment, I came across one mob, and it was a zombie holding a piece of string, and that was it. Okay. Gonna need a bunch of dirt, make a dark room, and I already have torches. So, where to do this? It's pretty easy to make a dark room in here. Spider. It's quite annoying. Okay, then we'll use that. Perfect. Perfect positioning for a dark room. Okay, so we need a fake floor. We'll start with torch. See if that works. And we need to actually make some carpet. Okay, annoying spider majigger, come here. All right, carpet. No, cannot place it on top of that. Although, I've heard that using a piston you can. Let's find out, shall we? A lever and a piston. Your mouse events. Grr. Oh, this obviously isn't going to work. there, there. Ah, no, that does not work. Alright. Next up, clearstone. Can we just place it directly on top? No, we cannot. And we cannot piston it either. So, that's not in this snapshot. I might leave this little experiment here for the next snapshot, because I really want to know if it's going to do the job. I need to... move this over. Need a nice clear way to get through. So I'll just... 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. That's all the resources I need to continue this experiment later. Here we are again. We are now in snapshot 13W18B. Let's see what happens with the experiment. All right, closed in. Shouldn't need this. Ha! Ha ha! Oh, yes! Look at that black light. Look at that block light. We have block light, and it's hidden. And there are no weird lighting artifacts. I think. Nothing going on. This is the solution to pretty much everything. This is amazing. There's one thing I wanted to discuss in relation to this. So that means I can change this floor to use carpet, and the light will go through. That's fantastic. So let's go back over here. Now, I've done some work on this since I last recorded. It's not done yet, but I wanted to talk about the fireplace. So the fireplace, as you can see, is basically three-sided, like so. So that means I'll be able to put lighting under these floors, not have to do ceiling lighting at all. So fire spread is all about the location of the stuff. This won't catch on fire. However, if I put carpet right there or there, it will actually be one block higher than it is now, and it will be able to catch on fire. I don't know if carpet burns. I would have to assume it does. So unfortunately, that means that at the very edge here, I need to use the full carpet blocks, so the carpet will sort of have a lip. I may use that as a deliberate design and outline the entire room, but it's not great. This thing's rain falling down my chimney onto the fire. It's pretty funny. So yeah, that's one drawback, is that you have to be really careful with fireplaces. But this is big. This fixes all of my annoyances with Minecraft lighting in a major way. I just meant it'll get rid of the rain for him. Well, we'll see. We've got somebody, Corey, is having trouble with his FPS. You see, I'm fixed at 30 FPS because I'm... Oh, not fixed at 30 FPS, apparently. Because I'm recording with Fraps. But yeah, this is almost done. I need to roof it off, get more stone blocks, and then do the floor. And I'm going to have to come back and redo other floors as well, because having torches everywhere or glowstone hanging from ceilings, it's okay for one or two rooms, but generally it looks bad when you have to do it everywhere. And if we take this room, for example, the hardwood floors, I had to lower these guys just so that we would get enough coverage from these lights that the entire floor was safe. And there's quite a few lights here. I'm not happy with it, you know? I really feel like they should make the lighting, instead of just, you know, from 0 to 15, actually be from like 0 to 63 and have light sources really pump out the light, depending on the light source you're using. That would really help a lot. What were you doing up there, Spider? Did you give me any drops? So there we have it. That's where we're up to. And in this version of the snapshot, I think I mentioned it before, the XP glitch that I showed off in the last video is gone. Which is another nice demonstration of Mojang's ability to kind of keep up. Just want to make a coal block just to see what it looks like. See if it looks better than wool. One coal block. It's basically a redstone block, but black. Ooh. Redstone block next to it. Let's see what that looks like. Can you uncraft these? Yes, you can. Maybe I'll go for a black and red pattern instead of black and white. Although, in that case, I'm going for carpet so I can do lighting, but still. What does this look like? Yeah, the black is definitely darker than the red. It's kind of neat though. I don't know. I'll have to think about it. So there we have it. New snapshot, and finally a solution to lighting that doesn't mean I have to have glass on my floors. I'm very happy. So I'm gonna get on that soon. I'm gonna get on that, redo my floors.